Now, our next guest has the magic touch when it comes to caring for animals. He's the face of Bondi Vet. He is the Bondi Vet and also a favourite on The Living Room. He's come armed with cuteness. That's just not his own face. He's got puppies as well.
How are dog?
They're gorgeous.
I am dying for a puppy.
Wow.
And, well,
how's the puppy going to fit in with all the cats? I know you just can't wait to own.
Yeah, I'm not a cat lover. What are these little?
So these guys are from the Animal Welfare League. They're Kelpie cross border collie puppies who obviously need homes. They were dumped on someone's property, so they. They're a little bit lonely and looking for love. So
that's beautiful.
Yeah, they're all border collie kelpie crosses, apart from this little one here, which looks like she has Australian Shepherd in her. So it's actually possible for a litter of puppies to have more.
These
than one
are so
father.
Cute that I'm going to go home and put my dog down so I can get.
Obviously, these kind of dogs, if you were going to adopt one, they need a lot of work, don't they?
Yeah, you're not looking at apartment pets here. I think these guys are going to need a lot of exercise morning and night. So the thing about any dog, really, is they do take up some time. And if you're going to keep them happy and allow them to
explore. How tall will they grow?
I look about sort of, you know, like a kelpie size. Yeah.
Is this one like Red Dog?
Just the same type of dog, but with a bit of border collie in there. So you're getting... border collie is the most intelligent dog in the world.
Yeah, that's
been proven by IQ tests.
I don't know if I want a dog that challenges me in the intellect department.
It's a really interesting point. Sometimes intelligent dogs aren't all they're cracked up to be because they work out your routines. Like poodles, for example, can be really hard to look after.
Oh, I like poodles.
Because you just want to walk them and they're busy solving mathematical problems and stuff.
The last dog I had beat me at Scrabble.
but what sort of temperament and what sort of families would a puppy like this suit?
I guess active people. People, you know, young couples or families where one of the parents or the kids are looking to do a lot of exercise and a lot of running, and you know they're going to want to play games, they're going to want to be stimulated and feel like they're a real part of the family rather than a pet that they can just sort of sit in the backyard with.
But it's good for the people too, isn't it? Because they get out and have exercise and live longer and feel better.
There was a study a few years ago found that dogs are actually a better personal trainer than a personal trainer.
Is that right?
Because you find it actually harder to say no to exercise.
Are you looking at pets with problems or dogs with problems on the next episode of Bondi Vet?
On Saturday night, we've got a new series starting, and we've actually got a very special case with a little girl who has brittle bone disease.
Wow, it's like and a 70s fondue party. We just swapped them.
and she has a dog that has a problem with its mouth, and obviously this dog means the world to us, so we have to try to right the wrongs there. And also we have a kangaroo. I have to treat a kangaroo that has a mouth infection. And you hear these stories about kangaroos sometimes fighting back and being a little bit tricky. This kangaroo kicks the absolute out of me to the point where I still have scars from this.
Really?
Yeah,
they can be pretty full on. Yeah.
And, let's have a look at it.
Oh, have we got video of you being beaten up by the kangaroo?
Yeah, I think.
Well, how's the show going in America while we're waiting?
Yeah, it's been picked up by CBS over there, and it's been interesting. I went over a few months ago, and you know how you assume the Americans sort of get it and they work out what's going on. They didn't get it.
No,
I arrived over there and they were convinced that I was actually an actor who played the role of a vet in an animal medical drama, to the point where I arrived to do publicity, a few interviews and that sort of thing. They'd written me in to two episodes of The Bold and the Beautiful. I was meant to be playing a role opposite Brooke. Short of riding in on a horse, I'm not really sure. I had to tell them, look, you know, I'm not actually an actor. What I do is real.
You could still act better than anyone on the ball.
Yeah, exactly.
I think that was their thinking. They'd sort of gone through all the acting world and realised it just didn't work for them.
You could have got a Logie.
Yeah, good-looking guy like you.
But this is the problem. The problem is you are so handsome that no one believes you're
so handsome.
True, mate.
It's
the key is
it's hard to know what's cuter, Doc or the puppies. Now, we need to throw to this very quick clip. It's about a young girl and her very loyal dog. Have a look.
I chose the Cavoodle because it was a small dog just like me and it's a good brand.
Daisy is much more than a family pet. Both Olivia and her mum have a rare condition called osteogenesis imperfecta, or brittle bones.
Olivia had plaster on for about 9 months this year and spent a lot of that time in a wheelchair. It is difficult as a parent to see your child in hospital. She goes there every 2 months to have infusions to help her strengthen her bones. And, you know, for a little girl to come home at the end of the day and know that she's got her little best fairy friend waiting for her, it's a comforting thought for her.
Oh, that is just gorgeous. Hey, we did hear about your show, but I just wanted to ask very quickly about
the dolphin
you
orgy.
Ending up in the middle of a dolphin orgy.
Yeah. Glamorous, isn't it?
Yeah. I always knew those animals were perverted.
Can you really blame them?
The thing is, everyone sees dolphins as being, you know, beautifully spiritual and these peaceful creatures.
But
they're sex monsters of the sea.
But they are sexual deviants, and I'm here to tell you the truth. So we were under there with them and watching them do their thing, and I thought that they were just being very aggressive to one another because they kept on bumping into one another, and it wasn't until we looked back at the vision we realised what had actually happened. We'd actually captured essentially dolphin pornography. And there was we tracked one of these male dolphins. He went between five different female dolphins in the space of a minute.
Oh my gosh.
What a guy.
He was dynamite. Wow. He was extraordinary. So
did the Barry White music in the background not give it away?
We piped it through the water and it really made things happen. But they're the only other species apart from us that do it for pleasure.
Yes. That's exactly right. Yes. Although I should warn people, do not type in the words dolphin sex for pleasure into a search engine.
Oh, Joe.
You get some weird stuff.
Yeah.
You get a knock on the door from the authorities the next day.
Now, you can see more of Chris Brown on Bondi Vet. It's on at 7:30 Saturday night, right here on 10. What a way to spend a Saturday. Thanks for coming in. Well, still to come, how 5 cents can change the world. We'll tell you how you can help next.